Friends, today we will see two new terms from the topic flow through pipes. These terms are hydraulic gradient line and total energy line. Hydraulic gradient line is also called as HGL, and total energy line is also called as a TEL. Hydraulic gradient line is a line which gives us sum of pressure head and datum head for a fluid flowing through a pipe with some reference. Hydraulic gradient line is a line which gives us pressure head and datum head, sum of pressure head and datum head of a fluid which is flowing through a pipe with reference to some data. That is called as a hydraulic gradient line. And total energy line, as its name indicates, gives us total energy, that is kinetic energy, kinetic head, pressure head and datum head, that is potential energy. Sum of all these three heads, velocity head, pressure head and potential head. The sum of these three heads is given by the total energy line for a fluid which is flowing through a pipe. We will see here with the help of figure. Here there is a container which is which stores water up to a height yet from the center of the pipe. Attached to this reservoir or tank, there is a horizontal pipe. The end of this pipe is open, so the liquid will flow through this pipe with certain velocity because there is a head H above this center of the pipe. Due to this energy, the liquid will flow through this pipe with say velocity V. We have seen the minor and major losses for a fluid flow. When a fluid flows through a pipe, there are two types of losses we have seen. One is frictional losses, that is major loss, and other minor losses are entry loss, exit loss, sudden enlargement, sudden contraction, etc. As the fluid flows through pipe, if we measure the pressures of this fluid at different points, you will find that the pressure is going on decreasing as we proceed through the pipe from this point to the last point. If you measure this pressure and plot it graphically, you will get a line, inclined line like this, which meets here at the center of the pipe, isn't it? And if you add to this pressure here, the data here, certain reference line, the sum of this data here and this pressure here is giving us the hydraulic gradient line. The pressures at different points you will get like this, and if you join them, all these points, you will get a line like this, which is known as hydraulic gradient line. Also, it is called as a hydraulic grade line. If you add to this hydraulic gradient line the velocity, because the pipe is carrying a fluid which is flowing with certain velocity, so it has kinetic here also, velocity here, which is equal to V square upon 2G. The pressure head is equal to P upon W at this particular point. But the velocity is constant, as the diameter of the pipe is constant, you get a pipe line parallel to this HGL line, but the distance between these two lines will be equal to b square upon 2g, that is kinetic energy. This line is called as a total energy line. This line is giving us the total energy of the fluid which is going through this pipe, which is potential here, z, because it is also called as a datum here, plus pressure here and plus velocity here. We know that there are three types of the energy for a liquid: potential energy, kinetic energy, and pressure energy. The sum of these three energies is giving us total energy. But what the line shows? The line shows the pressure at that particular point. If you take this point, at this point the pressure is equal to this much, and the velocity is this much, and the datum end is this much. Why we draw hydraulic gradient line and total energy line? Because when we want to design the pipe, we want to know the load on the pipe due to the pressure and velocity of the pipe. The pipe will be under certain load, under certain stress. This will be helpful us for designing the thickness of the pipe and selecting the material of the pipes. If it is a very short pipe, there will not be much major problem. But when there is a long pipe which carries liquid or water under pressure, it is a point of concern. So we must design a pipe which will withstand the pressure as well as the velocity here of the pipe. For that purpose, we want to know at a particular point how much is the stress or load coming on the pipe, so that we can design the pipe accordingly. We can choose the pipe material as well as the thickness of the pipe accordingly. For that purpose, the hydraulic gradient line and total energy lines are drawn. Okay.